How do you want to start it? Hey, this is Marty.
And I'm Nick.
And we're out Total Outdoor Pro.
Okay, cut.
Hey, this is Marty.
And I'm Nick.
With Total Outdoor.
So, I'm Nick. I mean, I'm Marty.
Hey, this is Marty.
And I'm Nick.
With Total Outdoor Programming. On this episode of Top to Bottom, we're going to show you all you need to know about catfishing.
Yeah!
Alright, so we're just going to go over the basics of what you would need for catfishing. This is pond catfishing, so we're not going to be going after any 30 or 40 pounders. It's pretty basic. If they were in here, we'd try, but they're just not. All you need is just a light to medium action rod. Spinning reel works best, and as far as the line, I'd probably just go with the 6-pound, 8-pound test. Give them a little bit of a chance, make it a little bit of a fight.
Sometimes with Marty, when he's explaining stuff, it's kind of hard to get a word in edgewise.
We're going to use just a basic sinker just to keep the weight, just to keep the bait down on the bottom quicker. And as far as the hook, 1-0 is probably about the biggest you need to go. Just a plain shank hook. So pretty basic setup. Just going to be fishing off the bottom. So there's all kinds of good options you can use for bait for catfish. Some people like to use night crawlers. I've even used hot dogs. Those work pretty good.
Why wouldn't a catfish eat a hot dog? Things are delicious.
But today we're going to be working with stink bait, which is just what it sounds like, something that stinks and draws them in. And this is going to be a mixture of chicken liver, corn flakes, and night crawlers. So you just want to keep mixing it. As far as the consistency, the only way to really know if you've got it right is to taste it. So just try a little scoop of that and see, you know, if it seems good to you.
Did we talk about that?
Oh, did I? I didn't mention that. Yeah, you just gotta try
it. You
can
just eat it?
Yeah, you just eat it. It's perfectly healthy.
Okay, well, don't the cornflakes have carbs in them? Let's go catch some catfish.
Alright, so we're going to have to do what we usually do on hunting trips like this and go ask Marty for some tackle, because I have no catfishing gear in my tackle box whatsoever.
Yeah, I usually bring 2 to 3 times as much stuff as I think I'm going to need, because Nick never brings anything. This time of year, the catfish are still kind of staying in the deep holes in the ponds, but then they'll move up onto the shallower flats as it gets closer to dark to feed. So it's really important to try and find those drop-offs and cast your bait as close to those drop-offs and those flats as you can.
So once you're sure that you have a fish on the line, take in your slack, get ready, and just set the hook, which means to pull up on the rod, pull the hook into the fish's face, ruin his whole day. Marty, your pole fell over.
And there goes the other one.
Uh-oh.
Get ready. That's a fish. That really is a fish.
Fish on! We're not getting skunked tonight, boys. Hey, quick release. That's the easy way to release them. A lot of people have a common misconception that these will hurt you. They're just feelers. They don't do anything at all. What'll hurt you on a catfish is the spine right here and here, and then the spine on the dorsal fin right here. Those things will stab you, and it hurts quite a bit. So you want to avoid that. If you're ever going to pick them up, just try and get your hands behind those fins and in front of that dorsal fin and just hold tight right around this jaw structure right in here at the base of the skull. That's the easiest way to hold him. So he'll make a good eater. We'll show you how to clean him here in a little while. One of the big problems people have when they're fishing for catfish Some people won't even try fishing for them just because they don't like this issue. It's trying to get the hook out of the catfish. Best tip I can give you, get a pair of hemostats. You can get them in the fishing section at Walmart. Typically used in surgery, but they clip on and they'll stay locked on for as long as you want. So you can get it locked on that hook and then you can just work the hook out. Got him?
Yep.
Alrighty.
He's not wanting to come in.
Man, I'm seeing quite a swell back there. Nice one. Oh yeah.
This catfish decides full grown midges out in this pond.
Yeah, you got a little close to me there, fellas.
What's the matter, cameraman?
Been fishing this pond for quite a while and their average size is getting better and better every year. Quick release. Didn't mean to do that, but that's all right. We've got the two we need for our cooking competition, so he was going to go back in anyways. Now in ponds, you can catch them all throughout the day, but you'll find as it gets closer to dark, they'll start to pick up in activity. A lot of times we won't even start fishing until the last hour of daylight, and then fish on 3 or 4 hours into the night. Sometimes I fish until daylight. They seem to be more active as night comes on.
Well, once it got dark, I pretty much put my stuff away and thought we'd be leaving, but these guys wanted to stay and fish all night. So it was pretty late, it was completely dark. Marty had one, he said it was big. So I grabbed the camera and ran out there. I forgot the microphone, so I'll just narrate the rest of this. So this is Marty reeling it in, and this is him getting it closer to shore, saying how big it is. I didn't really believe it. Nick seems to think it's big also. And then right as he gets ready to pull it out, that's the line breaking. And this is Marty reaching in ninja style, grabbing the fish with his bare hands and
holy
throwing it.
Holy sh**. Work,
Marty. I wasn't letting him go back in.
No.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. That was worth grabbing the camera.
So all in all, pretty cool night. So don't forget to check back next time on Top to Bottom when Marty and Nick show you how to clean the catfish.
Man, I think yours is substantially bigger than mine.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
And have their first Top to Bottom cook-off. And I guess then I will eat whatever they make. If you have any suggestions for recipes, please leave them below because I really don't want to eat something that tastes like crap. If you like what you saw here, leave a comment or subscribe. Even if you didn't like it, leave a comment and subscribe. The point is, subscribe. See you guys next time.